Fashion Week in New York, it's like the Oscars for Hollywood.
It's this incredible opportunity for designers, young designers and established designers, to really wow the fashion industry.
There are as many as 12, 13 fashion shows a day, and you've got models and editors and retailers and press kind of jetting all across town.
We run around from show to show every hour and hour trying to find inspiration to move fashion forward.
Hilfiger closes two of his flagship stores. Animal rights activists protest Oscar de la Renta's use of fur, and photographers boycott Donna Karan. All this in the wake of Fashion Week 2000, a week-long frenzy of models, designers, celebrities, and of course, runway shows. Here is True Life, I'm on the Runway.
Some excitement in fashion and some rock and roll and movie stars.
It's incredible. It's, you know, a million parties and all the shows and fabulous people everywhere.
I like to go to young designers because I like to know what's going on.
I love to know what's going on in the fashion world so that I can always stay glamorous.
You really feel the trends, you really feel what's going to be happening in the next few seasons.
You get to see the future. You get to see what's going to happen before anybody else.
I think the biggest trend is this kind of insane money kind of notion that was going on. Everywhere you looked was just this kind of insane barrage of fur and diamonds and crystals and leather and silk and satin. Really everything from a fashion perspective that you kind of associate with wealth and money.
Fur. Fun fur is back.
Aside from fur coats, fur jackets, you're actually seeing fur clothes and then fur accessories. There's also a lot of leather still, crocodile, alligator, things like that.
The suit, the return of the suit, is a key trend for fall.
Pleating was everywhere you can imagine. Pleated skirts, tops, just absolutely insane amounts of pleating.
There was a kind of a ladylike theme.
I think that they were trying to do something that, you know, felt kind of nostalgic.
They are taking inspiration from the 30s, the 40s, the 50s, the 60s, the 70s, the 80s.
The stronger the inspiration for the designer, the stronger the collection.
Anna Sui is one of those designers who, every season, and no matter what her inspiration, you get her point of view.
Before the show, you go through this whole torture of, oh my God, I'm never gonna have another new idea the rest of my life. And like, you start searching for anything. Like, you look through the TV guide, like, oh, maybe this movie will be inspiring. You also spend every day thinking, like, I need that divine intervention, like some bolt of lightning to hit me so that it all comes together. Whenever I do a collection, it's usually, everything is up on this board. So first, you have all these photographs and pictures and inspirations, and it doesn't really make any sense. And then slowly it gets shuffled around. There's a core and it kind of like spreads out. So you can see that like the core was the whole fauvism. And then I was looking at a lot of the Bloomsbury painters. So a lot of the outer core is Bloomsbury. And then right on the edges is all this Amish stuff. So you just never know. You can use like whatever it is that you come across and put it in, as long as it makes sense. It's got it, you know, like you can't decide this season it's Bozo, and everyone's gonna walk down the street looking like Bozo, when Bozo isn't what's going on.
I wore it, it's in the laundry.
It's the first time I've done an individual show of any kind of scale. It's very hard to get a runway show up and running. It's a huge event. And I'm lucky because I work with a great team of people who are actually all my friends too.
Yeah, they are a bit industrial, yeah.
It's surprisingly calm because I kind of don't really like craziness. I don't know that it really achieves that much, apart from making everybody else around you crazy.
Is this beachwear?
It is beachwear. You can actually wear this elsewhere on your body.
Vagabond song. Strange.
However, on the day of the show, I'm sure I'm going to be freaking out and, like, pulling my hair out.
That's not one of my inspirations.
No.
Funnily enough.
But it is one of mine. My real influences come from music. I mean, I love fashion, I love the history of fashion, but video directors, for instance, Chris Cunningham and Hype Williams. They really influenced my visual style more so than other fashion companies. This is very sort of early 80s Michael Jackson thriller period.
Okay, and that's it with the
models. They have to come in like three or four times and try all the outfits on. All the way through, we're deciding what's the theme of the collection and how is that best shown through the models that we're picking.
To have the right models in your show makes all the difference in the world.
I think the models' jobs are to dazzle us, to make those clothes come alive.
I don't know that it's about the big models. I think it's about getting models that really exemplify what your view is of fashion.
They can really bring life to the clothing. They can also take away sometimes.
Some girls won't get booked for shows because the designer knows that the press and the buyers and the retailers and the photographers aren't really paying attention to the clothes. They're more looking at the body or the hair or the girl.
The thing that I always enjoyed about the shows over the past 10 years that there was always an evolution of the new girls.
I think the standard of beauty right now is so vastly different than it was in the 80s and even in the early 90s. There is no more kind of glamazon supermodel image that you have to fit into or you're not a success.
I think it's really about the perfect blend of quirky and sexy, beautiful but different, and I think Angela Linval really embodies that.
Angela, about 3 years ago, just kind of crept onto the fashion scene and into fashion shows, and now is on every runway, on every magazine cover.
Angela Linval was a very strong presence at the shows, and I think she's a very big presence in fashion and beauty today.
I'm with you in the whole bizarro world.
Yeah.
Well, stress right? is worse than bad for your liver as well.
Morning, Ira. Morning. How are you?
Good. No, stay on the side, bro.
Hey, Ira, can we listen to some rock and roll, please?
I like doing runway shows. They're fun. You get made up into a different character and you put on clothes that you would never wear. And, you know, you become a character for each different show. It is acting in a certain way, like a clown or a mime. You've got to act with expression. It gets a little overplayed because you're doing so many, so you're a bit exhausted by the end. But, yeah, it's fun. Because I've done all the fittings. I know what the collection looks like. Yeah.
You like the other one better?
I don't know. I think maybe we had to see after, you know, like how it all lines up. I've had the meeting with the hair and the makeup, and everyone's on board. It's not in my hands anymore. It's nice, too.
It's chic, right?
Yeah. Okay, well, let me Polaroid this. And my friends convinced me to do my first runway show. That was fall of 91. We didn't pay for the space. We, you know, that got donated. A lot of people's time and effort got donated. We really kind of like put the collection together ourselves. I mean, there was really like not a whole lot of people involved. It was probably the most fantastic experience of my life.
They're not here. That can chase them by emailing Italy tonight and finding out where they were, what air bill, way bill they were sent on, and when they're going to get here. They left on Monday.
And it's Wednesday,
yeah.
So they should be here.
They should be here,
in
unless
the, morning, tomorrow morning.
The customs forms are filled out incorrectly, in which case. So at the moment, the only things we have outstanding are a box of clothes, which are missing somewhere between here and Italy, and two of the main girls that we're using, and three of the guys. But apart from that, everything's really going well.
One of the most complimentary things that people say to me is my shows are like rock shows. I think they're like a rock concert. And I think that part of it is the energy that we build with the audience.
Zoe's in town.
Great, and Zan's coming too?
Yeah, and Zan is coming as well.
And Sophia and her mom?
Right, Sophia great. Coppola and her mother, and then Michelle, mm-hmm. Hicks and Christoph.
This is the guy from Space Hog?
Yeah. I thought Kylie would have fun here.
Mm-hmm.
Vivian Tam mm-hmm. is coming with Scott.
Mm-hmm.
So that energy over here will be good.
The whole seating thing at fashion shows is not only very political, but it can get pretty kind of sticky.
When you don't like somebody in fashion, you really don't like them.
One magazine shouldn't be too near the other magazine.
Or you can't see this celebrity next to this celebrity.
Usually the people in the front and the first few rows are the people that are most important to the designer.
Then it becomes a question of who gets to sit in the second row, who gets to sit in the third row, who sits in the fourth row, and who you're going to upset. Who you can afford to upset and who you cannot afford to upset.
You can see there's like, you know, people eyeing their friends in better seats.
It turns into a little bit of a, like a junior high school thing, like, oh my gosh, she's in the first row and I can't believe I'm in the second row.
Second row is not so bad unless you're Anna Wintour.
As much as I think they must labor over making those seating charts, there are just so many people who are furious at the end of the day about it. You know, it would be nice if there could just be first and second row seats, but it doesn't really work that way.
I hope there's food here.
I'm not a glamorous girl that wants a circus around me catering to me and this and that and some movie star lifestyle. It's just not me. It's my work. I'm very fortunate to do it. I'm very happy. I enjoy it, have fun with it, but it's not the only thing I want to do in my life. My whole life isn't just about this, you know?
I wasn't on the runway, but I guess there were some kind of fur protesters getting on the runway with their flags. I think they literally kicked them.
They did.
They did? Did you see it?
Yeah. It was very strange. One minute, it was like just a runway show, and the next minute, they jumped up from the seats, ripped out their signs. They would bear hug them, tackle them on the floor, PETA people. But ask them, do they wear leather?
The PETA activists were ever present during Fashion Week.
Never before has politics been such played such a part in, you know, what I consider sort of our twice a year little soiree.
They threw some kind of red paint substance at Randolph Duke's show. They stormed the runway at Oscar de la Renta.
I thought it brought a sense of excitement and danger and, you know, real commitment to something that wasn't there in the clothes.
Interestingly enough, I think what it did was just publicize those designers even more.
Me.
Sweetheart, how
me.
Did I get
in? You have to talk to her.
Hi.
Natasha, these guys are from sportswear. Do they have RSVPs, right?
Go
okay,
inside.
I'll go.
Go in the backstage.
Okay. I say, oh, I'm really calm and everything, and on the inside, I'm probably having a nervous breakdown.
And Shirley, you come forward.
I'm sure that's the same for every designer and everyone involved in organizing a show.
And then when you hit the end and you open your coat, okay. Just like hold it.
Okay.
Hold it for a while.
Like, chicka-da-doo.
Yeah.
Hold it.
He needs shoes.
He's known he's got shoes. I don't know where they are, but I just gave them to his dresser.
Yeah, I have a few bucks.
You need socks.
He needs shoes, right?
No, he's got shoes.
No, he doesn't.
I just gave you.
Yeah, I have to give him that. Daring, so.
I gave you the shoes. I gave. He had the pressure.
Penny. Yeah. So the important thing is, it's not here. So let me tell
I just
me.
Gave him to him.
Yeah, so you know we moved away things. So let me just tell
he
me.
Lost them.
No, he didn't lose it.
Oh no, it's all going wrong. It's all a dream.
Different connotation now.
That adrenaline buzz is one of the great things about it, and hopefully you don't lose that.
It's like about a rock band going on stage, you know. You go on stage and you get the rush because you're getting a feeling from the audience, people are reacting to what you're doing. And if you do lose that, I guess the fun goes out of making fashion.
I don't think that reviews are the end-all be-all, but I think that it can definitely make a career.
There's definitely a new generation of younger designers that we are going to be able to embrace.
The Marc Jacobs, the Michael Kors, the Anna Suis, the Kenan Dufties of the world.
The younger designers are probably more influenced by music and rock stars because there's such kind of collusion between fashion and entertainment and music now. People are kind of involved on every level.
Like Anna Sui, she took a stand. She said, rock and roll is my life. It's what I love. The people who love rock and roll will love my clothes.
She completely understands how women want to dress to be eclectic and sexy.
She's not going to change from one season to the next. She's going to continue to present these really cool, funky, interesting, pretty, girly, sexy clothes.
Thanks.
Okay. Cool.
Well, we're here to see Anna Sui. We're from FIT. We're both students at
yes.
Fashion Institute. Actually down a ways.
Yes. This is correct.
Hello.
We are fabulous. We are good. We thank you.
Right before the Tiny Music Tour, she made me a bunch of suits for to wear on stage, and she also made a suit for me, a white suit that I wore to the Grammys that year.
Is it Prada? I'm wearing Prada.
No, it's Anna Sui.
I've done three shows today. I started with Michael Kors. No, I started with, I can't even remember who it was now.
My mother would always say, you want to be a dressmaker? And I said, no, a fashion designer. And it would always be this like discussion. Well, why don't you become a doctor? I mean, you could use your brains. No, I want to be a fashion designer. All I wanted to do was make beautiful clothes. I know for myself that my whole business is really generated from my fashion show. I don't advertise. And that whole budget is spent for the fashion show, and that's really what generates the excitement, gets the news out there. That's really where I put all my effort.
I don't know, I think people liked it.
How are you?
Hey. Anyone that's gonna come back is only gonna say something nice to me. But I think they liked it.
For me, Betsy Johnson is the best show.
Sean John, that was the one show that did it for me.
Anna Sui was a visionary overload, especially coming out of the minimalism and then the utilitarianism. So everything is very, very sort of simple, 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 and then pow.
I think I've always been really lucky with reviews because I've never had a really terrible review. It's so funny how out of perspective you can read a review because you can interpret a word, just one word, in so many different ways that like sort of could mean like they're doubting your talent, you know. So it's just like there's so much you can read into it, and I think it's how secure you're feeling about the collection. But then there's also times when I'm thinking, well, everybody liked it. Is it too normal?
I don't really tend to try and follow what's going on in other areas of fashion. I kind of go out there and do my own thing, and if that's right or wrong, then I sort of stand by it. Both of these reviews mentioned the amount of zippers that I use, and directly after the show, the zipper manufacturer that I work with then came forward and said, oh wow, can we sponsor your next show?
It can be possible that you're in one moment and you're not in the next moment. But in a lot of ways, if you've got a really strong look as a model, you can carry it off for a while. You don't have to, you know, feel like you're going to go out in a second.
Fashion is not brain surgery, and we are not saving lives, you know, by creating it. But it is its own kind of art form.
People put their blood, sweat, and tears into these clothes, you know, and whether people like them or don't like them at the end of the day, at the end of the show, the fact remains that 6 or 8 months of their hard work went into this, and it's a huge deal.
Fashion Week is all about that kind of energy and that kind of creativity and bringing it to life, not only in your clothing, but in your presentation and just the way you do things. It's all about that special spark.